listening to WRLR 98.3 FM Round Lake Radio.
Born in the USA, the demo version, the one you don't normally hear too often. That's even a little bit different than the cut that ended up on the Tracks compilation in 98. You're listening to Getting Loose with Bruce, heard every Monday here at 5 o'clock with your host, Ray Zirkle, on WRLR 98.3. And I hope you had a good week. And I decided today to go rare Bruce. And this is stuff you just don't normally hear. This is for the hardcore fans. Or if you just, like you said, you want to, if you think you know them and you want to know more. So this is, like I said, the first, like I said, the first one was Born in the USA. Of course, that was the original version. It was cut for Nebraska and then ended up later getting totally redone, of course, and ended up as that title track of the biggest album of his career. Next up, I thought I would kind of, I found three songs, all with the same title, or close to the same title, anyway. And I just wanted to play all three just to kind of give you an idea of the differences in them. And they all got the same word, name, I should say, in the title cut, in the titles, and that's Jesse. We're going to do Ballad of Jesse James, the demo for that, which is going back to 72. Another song called Jesse, and then the Jesse James song he did for the Seeger Sessions, that's going to be a live cut, and of course then he ended up naming his daughter Jesse, so he really likes that name, but let's start off with Ballad of Jesse James. This is the demo cut.
Thank you.
ends with a little flourish there. Ballad of Jesse James. Now, that's a demo that never got recorded and also never really recorded live. So that's kind of about as rare as you're going to get. And that one goes back to about 1971, 72, when they were pretty much still doing kind of rehearsals of him getting his, he hadn't even had a record contract yet. So, like I said, old stuff right there. Now, the next one was Jesse. All right, so we've gone from Ballad of Jesse James to just Jesse. And looking that one up, too, that one also is about mid-72 release. And really, didn't end up anywhere on any record or anything here. So, like I said, I wanted to try to get some really unusual and rare stuff here today. So, next one up, Jesse. Jesse. So, like I said, I wanted to take those three songs all with the same, I don't want to say theme, even though, Ballad of Jesse James. And this next one, which of course is Jesse James, the song that was done for the Cedar Sessions, has obviously got a common thread. Before I do that, I got a live read I got to do here, folks. It's WLR. RLR is a proud media partner of Lake County Women's Bowling Association, the USBC, which I guess is the United States Bowling Congress, who will be hosting the 2015 Illinois State USBC WBA, we joked about that being a whole lot of letters there before, annual meeting and state tournament in the spring of 2015. Their first fundraising event will be held at Culver's, located on Route 83 in Grays Lake on Thursday, November 6th. And that's from 5 till 8. And then a second fundraising event will be at the Panera Bread located on Rollins Road in Round Lake Beach on Saturday, November 15th from 6 a.m. till 9 p.m. Long one. I hope that's not a typo. that's a long one. I'm wondering if that's 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. But either way, check it out. Maybe it's an all-day event. So all proceeds will be used to help defray the expense of hosting the 86th Annual Women's Tournament of the Illinois State USBC, which opens on February 7th, 2015, and closes on April 19th, 2015. So for more information on their state tournament, the website is, now I'll spell it out for you, ISLCWBA.com. It's not supposed to be any particular word. Oh, I'm sorry. No, I did mess that up. I did. Here you go. See, I got to look at it closer. It looks like it's CWBA.com. So you folks can look that up. And if not, just type it in. It'll come up, I'm sure. So anyway, we had to let you folks know about that. And I'm going to continue on with my Jesse theme here. And number four we got is Jesse James from the Seeker Sessions, but this is the live version. Sessions tour. That might have even been from Dublin, but not 100%. Some reason it wants to go to the next track on me without me allowing it to. So now you know what I'm playing next. Obviously, like I said, I was trying to get demos and it's kind of unusual stuff here today. I went with my three-peat Jesse. And now before the break here, we're going to hit the demo for Fire.
When we
Mark, thank you, Sarah. And we are back with Getting Loose with Bruce. Heard every Monday at 5 on WRLR 98.3, the voice of Lake County. And this week I'm focusing on some rarities that you don't really get to hear too much. If you're expecting to hear Glory Days, you might as well forget it. So, like I said, I just wanted to find some unusual stuff for a change. I haven't done this in a while. Even though I do play rare stuff, that pretty much sold. Now, that last one, Fire, of course, he gave to the Pointer Sisters. That was the demo for it, and the little bit cleaned-up version ended up on the Promise, the extra tracks that were left off of Darkness, and that was put on that box set there a couple of years ago. So that was a little bit more cleaned-up version, of course. Now, these versions, I got these on a big compilation of songs of masters and rare demos many years ago, probably over 10 years, maybe 10 or 15 years ago. And delved into them a little bit today. And one song popped up again that I'd never heard of, or not necessarily didn't hear of, but it just didn't end up anywhere. First thing, I'm going to play three versions. It's going to be the first one's going to be the acoustic demo. I'm only going to play about a minute of that. Then I'm going to give you the full band version, E Street Band version. And then he tossed it off to Gary U.S. Bonds, who did it and ended up on his second LP that Bruce produced. So this is a song called All I Need. Back there, because that's for some reason that got skipped. The band version I wanted to play next. There we go. Here's the band version. Thank you. at the demo, the acoustic demo, the band version. So you think he would end up doing something with the song, but nope. Passes it off to Gary U.S. Bonds, ends up on his second solo LP with Bruce, and let's listen to that.
Thank you.
there you have it. That's a progression of a song from demo to full-blown recorded version. Maybe not all by the same person, but the song was written in June of 81. I would assume it was going to end up being for something, whatever his next album was going to be, which turned out to be Nebraska, of course. But I don't quite see it fitting on that album now. Maybe that's why it was put to the side. And after it was even soundchecked, then it ended up going to Gary U.S. Bonds for his album On the Line in 1982. So there you go. All I Need. Next one, I'm going to see here. I got 15 minutes left here. Let's go with this is a different version that even ended up on the Promise LP. This is the first incarnation of Racing in the Street. Just a little bit different than the one that ended up on The Promise. And, of course, way different than what ended up on Darkness. So let's give that a spin. And then I got two more after that if I can try to fit them in.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Boy, am I glad he changed some of those lyrics. Because I'll tell you, the great thing about that version is the harmonica. That's probably about the best thing about it. Those previous lyrics, not very good. I mean, if you really think about it, read them close. Like I said, extremely happy because it's turned into one of my favorite all-time songs of his. But like I said, it's got to be the redone version. Let's put it that way. Okay, so I got time for probably, maybe one, maybe two more. Before I forget, tomorrow, Outlaw Pete comes out. Find it at the bookstore near you. I would assume it's probably like the Barnes & Nobles would probably have it. But the new hardcover book based on a story that Bruce heard when he was a little boy. And turned into the song from Working on a Dream. And now somebody else has taken it and put some interesting animation to it. And like I said, Outlaw Pete out tomorrow. So next up, another rare song, again, going way back to 71, possibly 72. Prodigal Son. I don't think I've played this yet. Involved in a heavy-duty lawsuit there, about 15 years ago or so. And it still has not seen the light of day. So let's get that listed. And then maybe I can squeeze one more in before we got to go. But here's Prodigal Son.
In a place where outlaws are banned from the range, on a day that mountains have fallen to foes, in a land where boys are forbidden to grow, and metal is the only master, where the highway ends and the desert breaks, and buildings are bent from great earthquakes, and statesmen crawl on their bellies like snakes, and feed off the public hunger. In a land where skyscrapers scratch the sky, and delinquent daughters to their mothers still lie, Papa stands on the corner, he wants to beat the drum. Welcome home, my prodigal son. Great eagles have fallen from their lofty peaks, and policemen moonlight as sideshow freaks, for the final crime is committed. When presidents ride in Ford Mustangs, and the black man releases Cadillac fangs, and you're checked out in bed as the landlord bangs the young girl next door for the rent. Where telegraph wires are attached to your mind, delinquent daughters to their mothers still lie, Papa stands on the corner waiting to beat the drum. Welcome home, my prodigal son. When the telephone rings and falls off the hook, and your legs have been stolen by some defense department, you're starting to think about writing a book, but now you won't pledge allegiance to anything. takes it as a compliment, sticks out her tongue and asks for requests.
Everything there at the end. That's Prodigal Son that goes way back 1972 roughly, and again has not come out of anything except for some bootlegs, etc., and some other things, some other releases that got involved in lawsuits, etc. I really don't have time for the last one. Maybe I'll save that for next week. I can fade it, play it on the way out here and fade it out. It's just an instrumental that I thought was kind of cool from The Darkest Sessions for Candy's Room. It wasn't called Candy's Room then. It was called The Best Song. I hope you all had a great week. Have a great week coming up. And remember Outlaw Pete tomorrow in your stores, your local bookstores. And like I said, this has been Getting Loose with Bruce. I hope you enjoyed the show this week. And we'll fade out here with The Fast Song. And we'll see you all next week on WRLR. Thank you.